Good evening and welcome.
My mom always said, don't point. Yeah.
To the House Podcast.
Polite. That's not.
The House!
With your hosts, Mike Busa, Tony Liscotti, Marcus Wiedewelt, Chrissy Cefola,
and
special guest, John Zollo.
Zollo.
Yeah. Special guest, John Zollo.
All right.
Yeah. Wow, that applause really seems to grow.
That's right.
A good one.
You're good. Well, Mike, we finally got John here.
We finally did.
Let's raise our glasses.
Yes.
John?
Salute.
He's here.
Salute.
And he's ready to stomp Tony.
Uh-oh.
Tony, don't get nervous.
Oh, I'm already nervous.
All right, so for people who don't know John Zollo, can you give us a little background on yourself,
John? He's the one Jimmy Page stole his that icon from, but he changed over.
But just Tony is shaking over here.
He's been shaking all week.
Yeah. My movie trivia reputation is very
nervous.
Important.
You got him nervous.
Okay, yeah, well,
nervous.
Yeah, we're going to see.
I'll tell you what,
John. I got a tricky one, so we'll see what happens. But I guess before we get started, we might as well...
Make fun of Chrissy.
I told you.
That's why I'm here. All right. That's why I'm here.
Well, you know,
Chrissy,
it's just
if you had half a friend, you'd be half of it.
That's right. It's roommate issues.
No, it's not. We love you, Chrissy. We just dude. We know when we take your shirt off, it says Everlast. You're a punching bag. Okay, that's what it is.
Wow, what'd you do?
Okay, never mind. That's enough of busting on Chris.
Wait, no, I have some things.
Mike's not done with you.
I have a list of things.
Oh, see what I'm saying?
I'm just curious.
Come on, John, you got to bust on Chris.
I'm just curious.
That's Woody Woodpecker, isn't it?
John's not good.
Yeah. Thanks, Mark.
I'm corrupting John.
You see? You guys didn't know that.
Dad, Mike.
Okay, so here's the deal.
I'm ready for the beat.
No, I just had some questions. Like, there was this glass that sat here like that one.
That wasn't mine.
It sat here for like 4 or 5 days. I mean, is it supposed to pick itself up? There's a collection of them over there. See them? They build up on the side of the table. Is someone supposed to pick those up?
Wait. Is that why you left all those glasses?
Every night he leaves a glass next to the thing, and he tells me, "Hey, I'm gonna use it again." So, all right, and now it's like. Three.
What's going on? The glass last night when I came out here, I didn't think that was mine.
Bullshit.
They're yours.
But they're yours, Chrissy.
Yours. You're the only one that drinks that. Okay, all right. Okay, you don't have an answer. You don't have an answer. One more thing.
Of all the
chairs I got in this fucking place and the ones that you have in the garage, what makes you think I need three more fucking chairs? You know what I'm saying? We got a lot of fucking chairs around this place.
No, I figured that we put them in the backyard over there.
I got chairs in the backyard.
All right, that 12 in a fucking curb.
With the carpet that you keep trying to put out there?
Yeah, actually, you're right. You're right.
Damn.
And I was just telling John tonight, this fucking carpet's got to go.
Jeez, I just gave him a shiner. Mark busted a couple of your ribs.
You've been saying that for what now? Three fucking months.
I'm a procrastinator.
Tony, you threw a hook.
And one more thing, one last thing.
Mike put this guy through the MMA ring.
One last thing. I had some things. I figured I'd save it for the show because that's when we all get together.
Well, this is where you air grievances.
Yes. This is where I get evidence and, put it in
the
file.
On the air. Where else are you going to
do that? We could do that with Chrissy.
One last thing, and we can move on.
This is why I live here, John.
Well, the abuse is free.
I had a jar over there. It's a tip jar.
You should be able to. Chrissy,
jar over there.
Chrissy, you should be able to deduct that from the rent. No?
Wow.
Well, in that case, I shouldn't even bring this up because it's so petty. But it's like, it was like, hey, I'll take your $3 out of your tip jar. I'll pay you back tomorrow.
That was three months ago.
Am I supposed to say something?
No, there's a saying. It goes.
$2.
The saying always goes.
How long do I wait?
If you're good at something, you should get paid for it, right?
This is so bad. He could write it off on his taxes.
Yeah. That's how bad this guy is.
You know what, though? Yeah. I will put the $3 in tonight.
I knew he was going
to. Don't do that.
Why?
Because now you're appeasing us.
Appeaser.
Anyway.
Just fuck with you, Chris.
John Zollo is with us today.
Yes.
John Zollo comes from our time. This is his band. It was his band, Bone China, from the early 90s.
Early 90s.
Late 80s. My band, Hocus Pocus, was of the same genre. Yeah. We might have played a few gigs with you guys.
Absolutely, because I remember Hocus Pocus.
What were some of the clubs you played back then?
Okay,
Plus Five? What about Nobby's? Did you ever play Nobby's?
Nobby's, Plus Five, The Treehouse, The Button Set. We were in bands at the perfect time for South Florida. There was a scene. Right. There was a vibe. There was everything. Mm-hmm. And it's gone now.
What was your favorite place to play back then?
I'm going to tell you right now. Favorite place to play for overall sound quality, crowd, just the realness of being a musician. Absolutely the Button South.
I was just going to say that.
Oh, yes. But the best place to play was the Plus Five.
Was it? Really? Yeah, I like that place.
It was just a bar.
Like the
Plus Five. Yeah. You just got gnarly, and it was just...
Oh, I agree.
Do you know what I really hated was Summers on the Beach?
Yeah.
Do you want to know why?
That was a weird...
Because it was... I was the guitar player. If you're stage forward, I was always the one that's on the right. So if you're on the stage looking out, I'm the guy that's on the left.
Right.
And they had this big 300-watt can.
I remember that.
Would just burn your face because... Yeah. The ceiling was no taller than, a six-foot guy.
Oh, I remember being on stage at the Button, and the drum risers elevated, and the cans were right over your head.
Right there.
And a light man turned a can on over my head and never shut it off. I'm trying to signal him from the stage, dude, you're killing me. And then it reached a point where I started smelling my hair burning.
And then I
finally just with my hand, came with like 1,000 degrees. I just smacked it at him.
Right.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, if you got a ceiling that's only 10 feet tall, you got a can up there, and your stage is six feet high, the Smurfs could play there and get burned,
But well, that's paying your dues, baby.
That was like back
then. Yeah, it is.
Exactly. Paying your dues.
That was back then.
I also like the Treehouse. Treehouse.
Incredible.
Treehouse never got to play there.
Yeah. It was very intimate. It was small.
It was homey. It was cozy.
And I remember being in the dressing room, and there was a mattress in the bed in the dressing room. And I remember the whole band looking at that. I said, who's sitting on that?
Oh, my goodness.
Nobody. Nobody.
I wonder how much DNA is on that thing.
Oh, my God. I wouldn't even want to put a black light
on it. I put it nicely. DNA.
So when was that? It was when did you guys start Bone China?
We started in 88. And, we started like everybody else. Some hair glammy. And then you morphed into like what you became. And then the scene was it. Everything was just awesome. By about 92, 93, I was done. I was like, I'm out of here. I'm done. Burnt out. I said, this is, And, the funny thing is you leave the business. I think I was 24 years old because you're always hearing like, oh, you got to be young to make it. You got to be young to make it. Then you leave the business. And then years later, you find out the guys you looked up to, they didn't make it until they were like 30. Exactly. I'm like, man, I should have hung out a little bit longer.
Right.
Like,
you got up early.
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah. I thought didn't your band make it or something?
We were pushed to the point where we were packing houses, playing shows, and starting to negotiate record deals. And then what happened was you get a little bit of fame locally, and you see how the personalities just start getting, I don't want to do this, I don't want to do that, I don't want to do this. Yeah.
You mean other band members?
Yeah.
What a bunch of
idiots. They turn into idiots.
We had a formula that was working.
Like Joe Walsh says, everybody's so different.
And then everybody wants
bar
to do
star idiots.
And you're going, guys, we're not even there yet, and you're already losing grip. And everybody just had different opinions. And then it just got to the point where I said, I'm done with this. I'm done.
I can so understand that. You got to really hold yourself. Kudos for your own confidence to say to yourself, I made it that far. Because I'll tell you why. You found out firsthand, and we all find out because we hear legends and tales, if we aren't as lucky as you were, to actually get to the point where you're really close to the dotted line.
Right.
You would have signed the dotted line.
Oh, you signed your life away back then.
Signed your life away.
Yeah.
and always being very reluctant to do that because the record companies own your ass. You got to pay back all that before you see a red cent.
And you're so young.
You're so young.
Yeah,
and you want it so bad.
You taste it.
It makes you a puppet. They're like, oh, we got you. We got you.
And then I just walked. I said, I'm done. And then probably didn't play drums for 12 years.
Really?
Because I had such a taste. A bad taste, you know.
Disheartened.
Yeah, and then
same thing happened here.
So you understand.
Split Image with Scott.
Yeah.
And we did the Impact Productions. Remember Carrie Brewer?
Yeah, Carrie.
You know, we did our recording in Criteria and all that.
I remember Split Image.
And we built
Mark
up
and I were in that for
this
three,
big bill, and they went bankrupt and stuck us with the bill.
Oh,
and we had to end up playing gigs for, I don't know, 3 years, 4 years, pay it all off.
Well, it was cool because we were jamming.
Where Winslow got, he finally got the cuts.
Well, I guess this is the big time.
Hang on.
You guys made 36 cents tonight.
He finally got the cuts. Yes. Winslow got him back and paid him off or whatever. And that was in like 96. And I stopped playing until like 2005.
And then, you know, everybody begging
you. It was just so disheartened.
And now I play for fun.
Now look at us.
You know what? That's why you started anyway.
That's
all these cronies and clowns that made you fucking decide to not do it for a little while. Whether they got to you or didn't. You walked away, but you're still walking the earth, man. And you know that inside your heart that music is there.
Well, you stopped playing for yourself.
Right.
That's right.
Yeah. Okay, I'm playing because I'm scheduled here. I got to be booked here. I'm here. I'm here.
Right.
There's these demands, and then I'm like, I'm not even playing for myself anymore.
No.
You know.
I don't even like it anymore.
My mom goes, Tony, and she's a classical pianist. My mom.
Okay.
She's not by profession. She's RN, but she.
Right.
You know. And she says, all those stuff. When are you guys going to get a gig? When are you going to make some money? When are you going to get out there and make some? I go, Mom, let me tell you something. You're a musician. You should realize this.
Where's your money?
I am so wealthy, emotionally, spiritually, and everything that music has done for me, aside from that mighty dollar, which is the root of all evil.
Yeah.
And I told her, it's not the money's the root of all evil. It's the lack of money.
The lack of money.
That's all evil.
Well,
I told her, I never looked at it to exploit it as a profit thing that way.
But the people around you make you have, you know.
Right. You're nothing unless you make a dollar at it.
Yeah.
Well, I'll tell you how much I've made it. I've made it so big time, spiritually, emotionally, what music's done for my soul and set me free.
Yeah.
But that don't count.
No.
And you know what? If that don't matter to them, then fuck them.
No.
I still hold this fucking treasure with me.
That's right. And
I'm going to keep going.
They always used to say back in the day.
I'm going to play till I die.
Right. What's the difference between a musician and a pizza?
What's that?
A pizza feeds a family.
Good. I gotta say this one. I might have said it before on the show.
Drum roll.
And if it's still sound on Chrissy time, this is what. How can you tell the drummer in the band?
Oh,
he's the one hanging out with the musicians. Chrissy. Hey, what about the guitar player? Oh, he's the one that doesn't have a girlfriend. He lives in a dumpster or something. What is it? I don't even know.
He lives in a dumpster.
I don't even know.
What?
Between the guitar player and the singer, they always get the girls.
Oh yeah.
And the drummer always gets second. Sloppy second.
Does he?
Yeah.
I didn't know that one.
Tell
us the story.
I hate to tell you, Taz, that was your band.
Yeah, that must have been your band.
No, because we're all in the
That
band.
Was you, Chris.
You were Dry Bone China.
That was cold.
That's awful. That
was cold. What happened with the... So you just left. You just picked up and said, I can't do it.
Dude, I get it.
And you went,
I get it, too.
You get to know what?
You get to
and you guys
point,
understand
done.
This, growing up in Italian households, you get that lecture from your parents, this is what you want to do, we're going to back you, we're going to support you, we're going to give you all, you're getting a trade.
Yeah.
Because you
can't
plan,
B, say plan, B.
Plan B.
Plan B.
You have to have something to fall back on.
No, the best is, it's over now, get a fucking job. You're done.
Another personal rest from Chrissy.
There you go.
I'll tell you what.
Shit.
Mark, that one hit me in the back.
I'll tell you what.
That's for good.
It's over now. Get a job.
Get a job. You're not a rock star.
Yeah, but they told him
that. Is that what they said?
They told
go
that
grab
yesterday.
A shovel, kid.
Yeah.
He heard that yesterday.
Yeah.
So now, John, tell us about how you feel about what you're doing now.
Yeah. Well, now I'm playing for the love of playing.
That's and how is that working for you?
I'm loving it.
Exactly.
I'm loving it.
Because that's why you started in the first place.
I'm loving it. That's all I care about.
Isn't that the truth?
Absolutely.
Dude, that feeling, you know.
You're fulfilling yourself. And, and you know, not everybody else's expectations out there.
I'm going to say something. And my wife is standing right there.
So she is.
This is going to be a little weird. Being a young musician, being on stage with all your boys, everybody in this room gets it. Mm-hmm. You always had your girlfriends on the stage, and I know this is a family show, so I got to keep this as PG.
Oh, you don't have to do that.
PG-14,
pal.
I remember an ex-girlfriend saying to all the other guys in the band's girlfriends, they said, did you ever notice that watching them on stage is they look exactly the same as like when you're having sex?
Really?
Well, that's a compliment.
Because that love of playing.
It comes out of your face. I don't mean to say that. That's the wrong way.
Right.
Wow. So you're saying
you wear it on your sleeve.
So you're saying when a man has an orgasm, it's pretty much the same. Same look.
For that moment.
Yeah, I've heard that.
For that moment, every man looks like a musician.
Wow.
That's because that love is everything.
That is true.
That's because we feel every note, man.
Yeah.
That's why Tony, when he was playing in the
and every thrust.
Exactly. Oh, I got a son. You're a drummer. You know, there's a Vinny Appice. That stupid face, man. You know, see?
Oh, right.
Yeah, he's got that screwed up face.
Well, think about it. You hear Slash play. And the hair on your arm goes up. Mm-hmm. Only music does that.
The women musicians that are out there, when they're in their moment, they look like they just got an Amazon delivery.
Yeah. Mark.
Nice.
That makes a lot of sense.
That was a good one.
Yeah, I think so. Nice. The comparison is,
Gross. It's still gross.
Get one of the bars.
That face.
Right?
How do you feel about cover songs? Do you want to create your own music, or do you want to? Here's
what's weird. Like, you know how you got guys that started as cover bands? Oh, they started as cover bands.
Sure.
And there's guys that have a Rolodex in their head.
Yeah.
A million songs.
Right.
I never, from the earliest inception of me being a musician, I was always in real original bands writing our own music. I don't have this period of cover tunes. So when we decided to do this, I walked into my room, set my drums up, and I'm going, man, this is like the first time I'm learning other people's music.
I've never, and you see guys that could
walk on stage and go, oh, name the song.
Yeah. Well, because they've been doing it for years.
Yeah, because you know what? I'm literally
only going to know the songs I learned.
Yeah,
right.
Like, because I've never been a cover tune player, but I'm just enjoying playing so much again.
Yeah.
That to me.
That doesn't matter.
It doesn't matter. I just want to play.
Yeah.
Now he's not just walking around. He's floating around.
You're finding
that on your drumming journey, your percussion journey, or whatever. I always tell Dr. Rob about his guitar journey.
Right.
And he's coming so well along. Right. He's still so. At the beginning of it,
right?
That there's so many different things that can happen that influence your future. Your past doesn't matter. Your past matters. Look at it as your knowledge,
right?
Your
right.
Jedi archives, what right. you've learned,
and
that's fine. But
go so
Jedi
deep,
archives.
I was so deep into being a musician that it just immerses your life. There's nothing else in the world that matters. That when I'll never forget this. When I finally left the business. I quit. I said, I'm done. And then I wound up getting married. I'm sitting home with my first wife. Whoa. And I'm watching this show on TV, and I'm going, man, this show's hysterical. I said, is this a hit show? And my first wife looked at me. She goes, John, this show's been on the air, been a hit, and it's off. These are reruns. I didn't even know this. Like that period of your life when you are immersed into being a musician and chasing that dream, nothing in the world matters.
It's like, all about
that's right.
There's 7 or 8 years of my life that whatever happened in this world,
I didn't know, and
I didn't care.
You didn't care.
Didn't care.
Hey, look at it this way. Maybe you needed to do that. True. Maybe that's part of your journey to find it.
Yes.
Look, you're happily married now, and you got.
Oh, my God.
And now it's time for you to start pop, pop, pop.
When I quit for that time, you know what I did?
What?
I ended up playing video games.
okay.
that I never had a chance to play. Watching TV, but I enjoy things that, no, it's always practice. Every day, 6 days a week to play. I missed like an hour. 10 years.
Yeah, that's a whole span of time.
Things that I missed.
It's gone. But it needed to be, in your case, look at, we're sitting here under God right now.
Right.
Look at how you feel. You're enjoying your best, one of your best parts of your drumming journey after you went through that.
After all that.
Maybe you had to put it down.
You put it down, you walk away.
I think we all do.
That world you had was behind you. I'm married to my wife 23 years, who's the best thing in the world.
And, there you go.
Awesome.
You know, and that's it.
You didn't grow like it.
Yeah. And he's got new blisters on his hands.
Oh, yeah, I'm all getting all calloused again.
Hey, Chrissy.
I thought you got married.
You should be like...
And that ain't from jerking off.
Hey, Chrissy, he's got blisters on his hand. It wouldn't hurt if to pick up the sticks a couple fucking times.
Oh! You see what I'm saying, Joe?
Hey, you see what I'm saying?
I got blisters.
What happened to Chrissy's mic?
I got calluses, baby. And that's not from jerking off.
All right, let's do it.
I don't even want to tell you what was on the TV when I woke him up this morning.
Well, now you know you got it.
What was it?
Now you know you got it.
We don't need to know.
That was the other day.
All right.
I don't know, some chick had a foot in somebody's ass.
Was it a Twizzler?
No, whoa. Those were his whole movies.
All right.
Were you watching Spanked Revision?
Move on. Now,
maybe it was the Little Rascals. You know, spanking?
Who's your favorite Little Rascal? Alfalfa? Or is it Spanky? Now, one of the reasons that we're coming on the show for later on the show.
Wait, Mark's trying to be serious.
These two are going to duel it out.
That's coming up next.
Oh, yeah.
Are we done with talking about
it? He's challenged.
John's life. Is there more you want to finish up with anything?
We're good. Give us just a brief.
I heard you said something about they fucked you or something like that.
On what?
Bone China, no?
No. Everybody parted on good terms.
Oh, okay.
Like,
good.
And you walked away, and you knew you were done.
Again, you play for love, and then when the love was gone, you know, and then here's the thing. I think this happens to a lot of musicians, but when you make it and money's coming in, the money is the equalizer. You're like, all right, I'll just tolerate this because...
Exactly.
Because the money,
When you're dealing with that and not making money...
Yeah.
Okay, I'm out of here.
It's not worth it. Okay,
I'll tell you what.
You made money when playing? Yeah,
never. I'll tell you what.
Never.
I was just...
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. If I was, you would have stayed, but...
I'll tell you what, Mike will back me up on this. There's been many nights that we did gigs, we had to pay them because we drank so much.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Well, Surf Cafe with Nico McBrain.
Yeah, exactly. They call me.
I got a call at 3 o'clock in the morning.
I get a call.
You
from
got
Nico.
A bill.
I get a call from Nico at 2 a.m. going, "Hey, mate, the fucking alcohol is supposed to be free." I was like, "Oh, so I thought the same thing."
Well, it was for you if he was paying the bill.
I got one last thing to say in response to that. Remember Culture Room?
Oh, absolutely.
And when you have to tell all your friends and you give them a ticket, your ticket was highlighted in yellow thing. And as many of those people come up, then you know, if you get people to come to the club, do you know how much I made that night?
How much?
Oh, the guy who owns that place.
What?
He's got that, mask that they use to put mirrors up on the wall.
Yeah.
That's how his face was made of his
Did you make a dollar?
Greg?
I made 36 cents. And I told him.
Yeah.
That's not bad.
You keep it.
Yeah, exactly.
Well, then I got news for you. You've been the highest musician paid to this
day. 36 cents.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. You actually,
I feel like Lady Gaga now.
I think you got a record.
I make a lot of money.
We might have to borrow money from this guy.
That's right. Well, it's been long spent, but
being broke is such a joke.
Anyway, but one thing I want to ask you, one last thing before we, what's your favorite kit? What's your dream kit? What's your favorite brand and what would you
I'm actually playing it right now.
Great. What is it?
DW Collector Series.
Oh, wow. That would be just something. That's not just...
Yeah. And another thing. Also, you said before your influence.
Oh, John Bonham.
All right.
John Bonham.
Boom.
Everybody loves Johnny.
Pasties or Zildjian's or who?
Sabian's.
Wow.
See?
He threw you
Chris, when you leave a guitar player for this, you should be asking him this shit. All right. Thanks,
all right,
guys.
All right. We're going to take a quick break, and then when we come back... The challenge is on! I got a list of one-hit wonders, so I don't know how you guys are going to do on
it. Maybe I'll do good.
I don't know.
Johnny.
I don't know. Hey, we'll see.
I got some issues.
Are you nervous?
We'll see.
Maybe.
Anyway.
No. John's not nervous.
All right. All right. We'll be right back after this.
Dr. Rob in the house. And of course, Dawn's in the house.
Nice shot.
I've made better. Want to play?
I came to play Wisconsin skinny.
That's me. You a hustler?
Nope, salesman.
Break.
Salesman, huh? What do you sell?
Skittle pull
by Aurora. It's a lot of fun.
Why? Why is it always about me?
Well,
who's
yes, it has to be. Right, it's always
back.
About you.
It's always about me.
This is Bone China.
Yeah. Oh, this is Bone China.
That's Johnny out of Jones.
Really cool chords.
I just want to say me and Johnny have been together for a long time.
Yeah.
We have, brother. I love you, man. Johnny's my boy. Here's Johnny. Sway a little.
Here we go.
Light the lighter. Come on.
Yeah.
Wow. Ah. How about that, huh? Oh. Chrissy? See what the Bone China group did to you? Excellent.
I'm so excited. I just want to smoke.
I like it. I like it.
Wow, cool. That's really tough.
By the way, John, who was our vocals back then?
His name was Tony Black.
Really? I never met him.
That's a tough-ass rhythm. Right? The beginning of that sounded like... I don't want to categorize it.
Okay,
anything,
Sam was
old
the guitar
version
player.
Killer Scorpions yeah. or something.
Okay, would you have one or two guitar players?
Two guitar players.
Who's I remember you guys.
The other one
I
was
remember,
Dave.
Yeah.
Dave?
Yeah,
Bone
yeah I've always went in two guitar bands.
Yeah, awesome. I was
I like
with
two
one.
Guitar bands.
Me too. You have to do it.
Yeah.
No.
Yeah.
Well, it's always hollow with one guitar.
It does. When he goes to do a lead, the whole spinal cord falls out.
You know what, though?
I always wanted a keyboard player, but that's like... Every keyboard player is too good for you. Every piano player is too good for you.
Yeah.
You ever notice that? They never stick around.
Well, now, Mike, if you bring this back up a little bit. There's just two guitarists.
Oh, that's good. Yeah.
No, it has to be done
you're
right.
You're going to have to go back
now,
to
Johnny,
the beginning.
Now, Johnny, live, you had the same sound where you controlled the guitar players.
You live, you couldn't tell... Because we didn't do hardly any overdubs.
That's important. Yeah.
So that live, it sounded so just like this.
Yeah. See, now that's good. When you can work together like that.
Yeah, and this was my kill on command.
It's like,
guys, I think we should be shutting up.
It's like
missing
something. Once you get everything set up and you're live on stage and you got a guitarist going.
Good singer, Johnny.
Nice.
Sounds good,
I did
bro.
This. I put it back because we're babbling.
And we should be listening instead of battling.
That's all right. That's all right.
Listen, we can hear
Johnny.
Even though I'm deaf, I can still hear the fucking shit in the background.
Put it up because this gets really interesting.
It is good. But I don't want to focus too much on it because Johnny's not in the band no more.
I see what's going on here. Tony don't want to play the game. He's prolonging this fucker. He is prolonging this fucker.
You think
that's
so?
What he's doing.
He thinks so?
That's what he's doing. I see he's, where
he's
trying
to.
It was a low blow. The ref didn't see it.
Go get your fucking shine box, kid.
He gets like a yellow card.
Yeah.
Fucking yellow red.
Red card.
Come on, Chrissy. Wait. When have I ever been that way to you?
Let's just stop.
Every fucking day.
Come on, Chrissy. When have I ever made fun of you?
What's it going on, Chrissy? You got it. Yeah, you were on point. Uh-oh. Wait.
Spanning the globe to bring you the concert.
ABC Web World Sports.
Wait.
Oh, I thought we were called the thrill of victory.
He's here.
And
he's
the agony
right
of defeat.
Here we go. These two.
Here we go.
I'm not saying a word.
It's all about that.
This is vicious. This is going to be vicious.
I'm getting excited. My boy
Tony.
Where's Johnny? Come on, Johnny. Focus.
All righty. Well, we've been waiting for it all night. It's the championship.
One-hit wonder challenge. 2 months we've been waiting for this.
I've got to take my miner's cap off.
Okay. No, you better put your light on. Johnny, I got
this is how it all started. It started like one time we were doing a show, and John told me at a party. I was like, I nailed every one of them songs. And it was the one-hit wonder thing.
I think he's going to get
the problem is, Mike, I think you did all the ones I knew.
There's your coach. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
There's your coach.
Oh. All right, all right. He's working. He's working. Him with, yeah. A little
Yo,
prep.
Mick,
yeah.
You think he's ready to fight, Mick?
A little prep.
Man.
Yeah. All right.
I think I'm pregnant from you, Taz.
Simmer down.
You catch this, young man.
Simmer down. Simmer down.
Simmer down.
Simmer down. Mike, take control.
I got 20.
Get him.
I got 20 on Johnny.
Here we go.
Yeah, my mind's on John, too.
Here we go. Everybody. Olympics.
The torch shot.
It's the one-hit wonder challenge. Do I need the buzzers? I should get the buzzers.
Yes.
Get the buzzers, right?
Yeah. We need the buzzers.
No, we'll just scout them out. We're professionals.
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
You know, Tony don't want the buzzers.
You know what?
Come on, you forgot the game.
All right. Let's go.
We should put some money down on this.
No money. Money is the lack of root of all evil.
Ready? Okay, well.
Don't say a word,
I'm evil.
Don't chime in. Go ahead, Mike. It's all you.
Eye of the tiger.
Wow.
Oh, sorry.
Sorry.
Damn, that was like two notes.
Wow.
You see what I'm saying?
Well, wow. I thought it was that stupid Stevie Nicks thing.
These are easy ones.
Oh, that would be White Winged Dove.
Yes, thank you.
Right.
Good.
Edge of 17.
Aldo Pink Nova.
Floyd. Nope.
I know this one.
Oh, Billy Thorpe, like Children of the Sun.
Yeah! Wow. That's my boy!
Oh, my
God. 1-0.
Tony, have another drink. You're going to need it.
I can't drink. I'm sleeping.
Look at her butt. It is so...
Sir Bix-a-Lot. Baby Got Back.
Oh! All right, these are too easy.
What's that one?
You got to pay attention.
I'm going to move on.
Outfield.
The outfield.
Come on, Mike.
Starting off easy, bro. It's going to get real fun.
All right.
It's going to get real hard.
3-1. 3-1.
3-1.
3-1.
Johnny, you got this.
Here's a fight, Mick.
You all right?
Yeah, okay. Yeah, I'm all right.
You got this. You're my boy, Johnny.
Mick. I can't hear it.
4 Non-Blondes.
And I call myself a musician.
Wow.
Getting toasted here.
You're nervous.
Take a breath. Absolutely awful.
Focus.
Now remember.
Thanks, Chrissy. It didn't help.
My Love Is Like a Rock.
By who?
That would be, hold on. Marshall Crenshaw. Oh, Donny Iris.
Yes. Johnny!
There you go.
Wow. Microphone working.
Take My Breath Away, Berlin.
Tony. Hang on.
He's too quick. He's on coke or something.
Can we take a timeout?
Time
out. Let Tony focus.
Yeah. Can we get time out? Let my guy.
This is like a Mike Tyson fight.
He's on brain-enhancing drugs.
Mike Tyson is putting an insulin.
Oh, my God.
Mark, take your guy in the corner and talk to him.
Yeah, let's talk.
Thanks, Nick.
Talk to him.
A prep talk.
Come here, Rick.
Come on.
What happened,
Bobby?
Who's Mick?
He's okay.
I need him now.
It's too strong.
Don't talk like that,
Rocco.
Come on.
Just help me.
Yo, Mick, I wish we was chasing
Shinkins.
Johnny,
we got this.
We got this, Johnny. It's in the bag, kid.
I can't see. There's like three of them.
Hit the one in the middle.
Hold on. Focus.
Go.
Mexican Radio Wall of Voodoo.
Yeah, baby!
Didn't I foresee this?
I'm on a Mexican.
What's it, 15 to 1?
Just remember. Yeah.
Are you looking for substitution?
No. I'm looking for I can crawl into a hole.
Would you like to call a friend, Tony?
Nobody gonna break my stride.
He watches MTV when he's out there.
He's too quick. He hears three notes. That's it.
Dude, he don't know the shit,
you don't know
bro.
Where it is, though. How about this one?
All right.
Aha.
Oh, my God.
Take on me.
Tony.
That's a drum beat.
Tony. I told you.
Dude, you are this? Much better than
All right, now it's going to start getting harder.
I've already relinquished the crown.
You should have practiced.
All right, now it's going to get a little harder now. Let's see how good he really
Chrissy,
is.
Chrissy, go get your gun so that he may have vanquished me.
You want me to go get my shoebox?
No, okay, let's
you
go.
Want to get
come
my
on,
shine
Tony.
Box?
Come on.
Come on, Tony. Yeah, you know something.
Come on. I know
nothing. Pee Wee Herman.
No, I think it's Oingo Boingo. The future's so bright, I got to wear shades.
Yes. Oh.
Oh. Oh.
I don't know any of this fucking gay shit. Oh, Hedy's.
Yep, Tony gets one.
Gets two.
What, who was that?
It's Hedy's.
Hedy's. You want, I wouldn't have gotten that.
Really, John?
He would have gotten it. Love just it, give right? him a 2-point millisecond, he would have gotten it.
Tony, you feel better now?
Better than a white line.
Tony, you feel a little better? It's a great song.
Yeah, it actually is really good.
Oh, dancing in the dancing in the
Van
moonlight.
Morrison.
Dancing not Van Morrison though.
No, no, dancing in the moonlight.
King Harvest.
He knows Harvest. HR Puff and stuff.
Yeah, right. Jimmy, help me, Jimmy.
Yeah, I don't know what the hell that was.
Come on.
My love is alive. And that's Gary Wright.
Yeah. Okay, wait.
Hold on.
Now,
my guy's getting smashed here. Hold on.
No, not smashed.
What's your guy?
Come on.
Fucking damaged egotist. I need you to tell me when the beginning of this thing is going
to be. I'm sorry, he's throwing me off.
Fucking bam, 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 bam. I'm like,
this is really something else.
Cut
wow.
Cut him.
Okay, wait.
For the punch.
Now, a couple of seconds of silence and then...
Okay.
Okay. Right. Okay. Right. Thank you.
All right. Let's do the
new
silence.
Song. This is a tough
Tony,
one.
Give silence.
Tony, give Tony a
silence.
I predict no one gets this one.
John, give him a couple.
But then again,
Toma bone. Toma bone, John. It's getting harder.
I have no idea.
Singing.
Okay, take your time, Tony. Focus.
Tony doesn't know
what
he
is. No.
Oh, is it Fiona Apple?
Oh! Oh! Yeah! That's my boy!
You're loving this, aren't you, Chris? You're fucking loving it. I'm fucking diving here.
Dude, I got a C-note on here, bro. I got a C-note.
Dude? You're like my buddy, and now you're fucking this guy toasting me, and you're fucking loving it. That's like good fucking...
I know I'm going to get John. I know after the show I'm going to get beat up tonight. I better lock my door tonight, John. I better lock my door.
You're going to make a run right here.
That's like John Madden commenting the football game. He's like, yeah, Steelers!
You're going to make a run.
It was on the line. It was on the line.
All right. Silence.
Silencio.
Silence.
Silencio.
Silence.
Hold on.
Captain
different
Brown.
Drugs for different folks.
Been 40 days since I don't know when.
I don't know this
I just
town
saw
here.
Her with my best friend. Do you know what I mean?
What I mean? I don't know what you're saying.
All right, come on.
Do you know, know what I mean?
I don't know.
Yeah, Lee Michaels, no.
I just saw.
How about this one?
Dionne Warwick.
No.
Thanks, Mike. That sounds so good.
It's the ice cream truck. I want Mr. Soft.
Shh. Come on.
This is a great song.
Yeah, it is.
It's a great song.
Chrissy!
Oh.
I know this, but I'm such a loser since John's been here tonight. I can't fucking...
Hello, my love. I heard a kiss from you.
But it's not Earth, Wind, and Fire, though.
Red magic set and play near.
Well, hearing that bass line, Mark's got to know.
Yeah, it's like true. So, yeah.
I agree.
The strawberry,
the sun doesn't shine.
Yeah.
Right. Strawberry. Making it if we weren't Andy Warhol.
In the garden, well, this is John.
Yeah, y'all hear that bass line?
Oh, here's one.
That everyone, I always right. used to say, we played with this guy once.
All right, first,
silence.
Silencio.
First. Let Tony, let my man call. Right, silence.
Oh, I know it. Yeah, you're right, Mike. Yep.
Oh.
I heard it though. You ever heard it though?
I've heard the song. I do not know the
Wait.
Is this Grand Funk?
No, it's Blue's Image.
Is that Grand Funk?
Never would get that.
Mike Panera.
Yes, remember?
Yeah.
Like Panera Bread?
Yes. Wait, was that Grand Funk?
No.
No, no. This is getting tough, huh, John?
Yeah, that was good.
Tony.
It's not tough for him. He's 15-2 here.
No, no. And you know what? It does sound like Three Dog Night, but it wasn't.
God. I demand to meet a rematch. Call Don King.
All right. Okay, should we get into the...
Silence.
Let's get into something so I can get some points.
Fixed. All right, silence.
This is all fixed.
Silence.
What 70s TV star...
Oh.
Okay, no.
Had this hit song in 1970.
David Soul.
Oh, my God.
Oh, my God.
Whoa!
Johnny, you're my boy. Oh, my God. Tony, you want to
go? No, I don't want to continue.
No. Oh, come on.
Clearly, this whole alien thing that's been going on lately.
Mike.
No. I'm not willing to continue. This dude's clairvoyant, okay? He's a fucking sorcerer or something.
Mike, what are we looking at? What's the score?
We're not even keeping score anymore.
Okay, maybe five more so I can try to redeem myself.
Tony, he didn't have to call a friend.
He didn't even fucking play the song.
He can play that.
This is ugly.
Hey, Tony.
Ugly.
What's your middle name, Kreskin?
He can name that song. Yeah. He can name that song with no notes.
He can name that in zero notes.
Remember that guy in the Merv Griffin show, Kreskin?
Yeah. He can name that song as zero notes.
Give us one more, Mike. Come on,
Kreskin.
Oh, it's a great
song. Oh, Brandy.
Right,
the Looking Glass.
You want to know something? That's another band that everybody thought it was Three Dog Night.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Brandy.
Isn't that the Doxadan commercial?
Nope.
Doxadan.
Oh, you're in trouble.
Oh.
Oh.
Oh, Amy. Buffalo Springfield.
Oh, my.
Not close, though.
Oh, hold on. Amy. I know it's Vince Gill singing.
Listen to her voice.
Tony Woodson's trying.
The Eagles? What?
Amy, he got it.
Pure Perry Lee.
Oh, Pure Perry.
Yeah, he got it. Amy.
All right. You guys remember this song? You're not going to get it, but do you remember this song? Because I remember this when I was like 7 years old.
Go ahead. Oh, fuck yeah.
Yeah.
You guys know this?
Yeah, I got it.
Yes.
I got it.
Yes. What's his name?
Bumble
and
the
Stingers, Martha Cooper, Rachel
Singers,
Lonnie Mack, Twang, and Eddie.
The first rap song.
Yeah, really?
Yeah.
This is the first rap song. Baby, gotta give me. Yep, I don't know who does it.
I never heard the song.
Never heard the song? Oh, my
God. Dude, this was like 70-something.
This is fucking awesome song. All right. Jimmy Shimmer's Cocoa Pop.
Who's the biggest hit?
Rob, you know it? You know it?
All right, that's enough beating for one night.
That's enough fucking candy.
One more.
I went through the round with Tyson, and then they threw me in a gulag.
Wait, you got some movies?
Try movies.
Try some movies.
Yeah.
Let him desecrate me some more.
No. Tony, this is where my man shines.
Beat me to a pulp.
This is where my man shines.
Listen.
Silence. She blinded me.
Scarface?
Yes!
Oh!
Told you. This is where my man is. All right. We're going to pull it up. Let's go.
So here's your comeback, Tony. Focus.
Your comeback.
Try to believe, though the going gets rough, that you got a hand tough to make it. History repeats itself. Try and you
Rocky.
Succeed.
Never over the top.
The one. Very close.
And you can have your
I
dream.
Think it was in both movies.
The
Oh, oh, yeah.
Wait.
Chronic
Hit.
Tony, I'm going to tell you something right now, Tony. This don't feel good.
Oh, now you're on the other end.
Don't feel
this,
good.
Huh?
I'm not liking this.
Silence.
Silencio.
Wait.
All right, Johnny, come on. Have faith.
TV shows.
It's like a fucking honeymoon.
That was from what?
Fantasy Island.
Oh, my God.
The plane. The plane.
Tattoo, you are the perfect height to suck my
dick.
All right, wait.
Oh, fucking Incredible Hulk.
Yeah. All right, right now.
I get very depressed.
Coming up.
Don't matter no more. He kicked my ass.
No. Come on, baby, focus.
Are we ready to wrap this up or are we going to keep going?
Yeah, it's after
9. You guys got to get going.
Yeah, let's wrap it up.
You know what, guys?
Yeah,
I know John.
Again.
I know John forever. He's my best friend.
I've been defeated.
We waited a couple months for John to come on.
It was well worth it.
He relinquishes the crown.
I've enjoyed myself.
I relinquished the crown.
I'm
going to miss it sitting on my girlfriend's ass.
It's okay, Tony. Tony, it's all about having fun.
It's all about having fun, Chrissy.
John, it was great tonight.
Oh, dude, awesome.
Hanging with you and talking to...
Oh, yeah, by the way, Chrissy, you're fired. We found a new drummer. Yeah.
Dude. He sounds like a mechanical drummer.
That was cold-blooded.
That was Tony. Check in and see.
Don't take that shit out of our paper.
That was good. I love Chrissy to see.
It beat you up.
Wow.
All right. Good night, everybody.
Good night. See you next time. Hit the button.
We out.